Привет всем, продолжаем проходить Уануар. Не забываем подписываться на канал, ставить лайк, ставить комментарии. Всем заранее спасибо.
Ah, Phelps. I was just discussing with Finbar here how well you were doing. Have a seat.
Yeah, my real name. And you can just forget all about it.
You boys have a new case. A poor Hispanic woman murdered near City Hall and left lying naked in an alleyway.
Another naked woman, sir?
Yes. We seem to have had quite a run of them since the Dahlia fiend first struck.
Phelps is politely trying to hint that he thinks the Mendez case is hokey.
Well, young Phelps, you win some and you lose some in police work.
You're happy with the Mueller case, sir?
Over the moon, boys! The DA couldn't be more pleased with the evidence, the witness, and the lack of an alibi. Now, get out there and catch me another sinner.
You have the address?
It's the alley off Aliso between Los Angeles and Alameda.
You're kidding. The next one will be opposite Central Station.
Count yourself lucky. Most guys would kill to land a case so close to their death.
Yeah, it means they can pop in to hit the office supply of hooch whenever they need it.
You know, that ain't a bad idea. That is not a bad idea at all, Phelps.
My unit's officer needs help. Bank of America, 7th and Olive. Officer needs help. Bank of America, 7th and Olive. A 211 in progress and shots fired. Unit to handle code 3, identify.
What's the situation?
Half a dozen shooters, sir. Cold-blooded sons of bitches. Real professionals.
What do you mean?
Witnesses say they bounced in, aced the guard, and went straight downstairs. Christ knows who they're working for, but whatever's in that vault, they want it bad.
You picked the wrong bank to rob, my friend.
Guns. Oh, you clever asshole!
They've blocked the goddamn stairs. Detective, take the elevator.
All right, I'll wait here.
Don't give them a chance to regroup.
Wish me luck. Your buddies upstairs are dead. That leaves you now.
Come on, Cole, what's taking so long? Real clever, asshole! I'm gonna find you! You're fucking up!
Just you and me. You can live to tell the tale.
Give it up, chump. I know you're there.
That's it. That's all of them. Car 11K. Shots fired, suspects are down. We're code 4 here, but I need an ambulance at Bank of America. 7th and Olive. Notify coroner and detective headquarters.
Roger, on your ambulance 11K, all units code 4 on the 211 and Bank of America, code 4.
There.
Thank you. Cole. Come on!
Detectives, they're ready to start the show. I'll take you through.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Brothers, Pinker.
Cause of death is pretty apparent. We thought we'd best wait for you when you're ready.
Lacerations on the neck would indicate a great deal of force. Only 21 years old. But why the library card? Did he want us to find it? Another wedding ring torn from the finger. No skin under the fingernails. Kiss the blood, BD. The evidence in the Mueller case was solid. I'm not convinced about Mendez.
The best way to get away with murder is to pin it on somebody else. I'll bet a month's salary this is a copycat.
Strangled, battered.
Yeah. We know the M.O. So does every jerk who kills his wife and girlfriend looking for a way out. I've spoken to Brown. He still believes the Dahlia perp has medical experience.
Four women, all murdered, all put on display, all with messages.
Mueller had no message. Look, Phelps, this is getting us nowhere.
Anything for us to go on, Mal?
Head injuries from contact with Road. Bruising from a small man's shoe. Further blunt force trauma to the occipital region at the base of the skull. Could have been fatal, but clear signs of strangulation would seem to rule it out.
Lipstick appears to be a similar color to the other cases. I'll see if I can nail down a brand.
I need to get back to it, Phelps.
May as well follow the trail. If she took a blow to the head like the others, she was probably unconscious when strangled. Thank you.
Phelps, you'll want to come and take a look at this.
Just what I think I've seen it all.
I'm not kidding, Phelps. Come see, now.
Antonia. Huh, same as the library card.
Never the same, are they?
proximity to the scene, plus the bloodstains, no way is this coincidence.
Kept the area pristine for you boys. Let's check it out.
House keys strung up like bait on a hook. Think he's trying to lead us somewhere?
Probably all the way to City Hall, that brazen son of a bitch.
That's got to be a code or a cipher. Empty. Where is all of this meant to be taking us? He clearly wants us to find these things. He's left them for us.
There you go, Phelps. We got a new MO. I told you it wasn't our guy.
Or he might just be getting more confident. Enameled and gold-plated. This was precious to her. The trail points up. Here. What's the significance? Looks as though the killer was decorating with this. Son of a bitch, once her identified. Mrs. Antonia Maldonado, 712 North Hill Street, downtown.
Was Mrs. Maldonado, right?
That's affirmative.
All right, so then there's a husband we should be looking for. Get him, we've closed the case.
Rusty's razor, of course. I don't want to question your tried and tested techniques, Detective Galloway, but doesn't the DA require sound casework before he'll close the book?
Not if he's got a confession. And, you know, there's ways of getting those.
I'm sure.
Good looking for a policeman.
Wait just a moment! I'm sorry. Can I help you?
LAPD, ma'am. Detective Phelps and Galloway. Does Mrs. Maldonado live here?
Yes, she does. I'm Mrs. Barbara LaPente, the owner of this boarding house. Is there a problem?
I'm afraid so, ma'am. Do you mind if we come in? Is there somewhere we can discuss this?
Of course. Follow me through to the parlor. Wipe your feet as you come in, detectives. It's this way.
Mrs. Maldonado was found dead this morning.
Dead? Oh, no. She can't be.
I'm afraid she was murdered, ma'am. We need to take a look at her things.
I can't believe it. A person seems so alive, and then they're gone. Antonia's room is upstairs, last door on the left.
Thank you. We'll be back shortly.
Excuse us a moment, ma'am. What are we waiting for?
Will you look at that? Someone's turned the place over.
A smashed window explains why the place looks tossed.
You know how I feel about windows, Phelps.
So someone broke in using this thing instead of a crowbar. I wonder where it was taken from.
Okay, we have an address.
Charm bracelet wasn't among the crime scene evidence. We have some questions, ma'am, if you're up to it.
Yes, Detective. I'll do my best.
Do you have any idea who might have wanted to hurt Mrs. Maldonado?
That rat of her husband, Angel. She was serving him divorce papers.
If I killed every wife to serve me papers, I'd be a mass murderer.
Are you being flippant, young man?
No, ma'am.
What can you tell us about Angel Maldonado?
She married him when she was 17. He was cruel to her, very cruel. She was a good girl, little on the religious side, but a good girl.
What time did Antonia go out yesterday?
She left around 9.
Do you know where she went?
No, I have no idea. She was a good girl, but she didn't confide in me.
A nosy old hag like you knows everything about the people who live under her roof. Where did she go?
I think she went to a bar. She's been drinking quite a lot lately.
This bar have a name?
El Dorado Bar. It's a Latino place on North Los Angeles Street.
That's only a couple of blocks from where we found the body.
You've had a break-in?
No. That can't be true.
You're being economical with the truth, Mrs. Lapenti. What do you have to hide?
I have no idea what you are talking about.
So Antonia lost her keys and used an iron bar to jimmy the back window?
I heard a noise in the early hours of the morning. I thought it might be a raccoon at the milk bottles. It'd be very bad for business if this news got out. I have a reputation to protect.
Antonia and her husband were estranged?
Yes. She moved here after she separated from her husband 2 months ago.
But Antonia still wore a wedding ring?
She wore the wedding ring and a necklace. She always wore a religious necklace. That's about all of her jewelry.
What about her bracelet?
I don't know anything about a bracelet.
In her wedding photo, she's displaying a charm bracelet.
That thing? She never wore it. He gave it to her. She always kept it in that wooden jewelry box.
Thanks, ma'am. You've been very helpful.
Pay a call to that husband of hers. Lock him up and throw away the key.
We can either front Angel, seeing as the finger's pointing right at him, or we could check out the El Dorado bar.
A nosy old hag? Ha! And I thought I was coming on strong with the XY's line.
Sometimes you have to be firm to get the information you need.
God damn it, ain't that the truth.
You don't think it's strange that all these murders are happening to girls who've been out drinking?
No, no. A broad drinks, she gets a bit tight, she starts mouthing off. This leads to that, and she ends up in an alleyway. It's a sad story, but this town's seen it play out 1,000 times, Cole.
Why don't you want to see a connection here?
Because there are perfectly good real-life suspects for every one of these murders. We don't need to go looking for the monster under the bed.
Think there's anything to the divorce angle?
I've been through 3, though. No big deal. After a while, you just numb yourself with the experience.
But Angel, he's a young Latino man. It would hurt his sense of who he is. He'd see himself as a failure, a woman taking control over his life.
Then she fronts him and he snaps. Works for me. That makes Angel a killer as well as a piece of shit.
Thank you. someone!
Can I get you?
LAPD. Detectives Phelps and Galloway.
Diego Aguilar. How can I help?
You worked the bar last night?
Yeah. Me and a temp guy from the agency.
Did you have a woman in here last night? 21 years old, Hispanic, drinking heavily?
We have a lot of ladies like that in here. But yeah, I know who you mean. Antonia Maldonado. Oh, what did she do?
She was murdered last night.
Oh, shit.
Do you know her well? Was she a regular?
Hell no. She was good and tight last night, complaining about her old man. It's a story you get used to working in a bar. She was so hammered last night, she left a letter on the bar. I'll show you.
A waitress! Can I have another spoon?
Where's that goddamn waitress?
Divorce papers? Did you open them?
No need to. She was shouting about it and waving the letter around. Said she was gonna show him.
Can you remember what jewelry she was wearing?
She had a necklace. Some kind of religious thing, I think. You know, the temp guy would have more of an idea. She took the beer he served her and cried into it all night.
What time did she leave?
Can't say for sure.
Where did she go? Give me something or the LAPD will start getting interested in this place.
Take it easy. She wanted a cab, okay? And my phone was out of order. The closest one I knew was at the fruit market across the street, so I suggested she try there. She seemed reluctant.
Did Antonia say where she was going when she left?
She said she was going to serve the papers on the husband. Said that would take the smile off his face. If you ask me, she was scared. And the drink was for Dutch courage.
She attract any interest?
An extremely drunk young woman? What do you think? She managed to scare them off, though.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
No problem. Hey, get the guy, will you?
We'll do our best. One last question. What size shoe do you take, Mr. Aguilar?
A broad 9. I have wide feet.
He drove me up to Mulholland and we did some necking.
Say, honey, what time did you get off waiting tables?
Out of the car, police!
Hey, what are you doing?
shut. Great. We'll need to come back later, Phelps. Maybe somebody here saw Antonia the night she died.
Cop who solved the big case and got promoted.
This guy was willing to rat his own mother after I'd sweated him.
Won't buy me something nice. I'll find someone who will.
How about we drop in on the husband instead? See if your gut is right.
I'll take a bar over a husband every day of the week.
That's the cop from the newspaper.
Phelps, this could turn ugly. Forget about knocking. Let's take our boy by surprise.
Hey, what the fuck?
LAPD, motherfucker, you're under arrest.
I got it. Now look. I got something to say to you.
Thank you. Damn. They got some decent shots in there. Cuff these sons of bitches, Phelps.
LAPD, you two are under arrest. Call for some backup, Finbar.
Galloway, badge number 564. I need a prowl car at the apartment building 330 North Hill Street. Two suspects need transporting to Central.
Your wife has been murdered, Angel.
Antonia? Oh, God, no!
Where were you last night, Angel?
I was here with my brother the whole night, goddammit! You think I could kill my own wife?
We should get the whole place going over, then talk to the neighbors. And Phelps, I don't care that you just got smacked in the head. You don't call me Finbar.
This will take some explaining.
Maybe one of the neighbors took notice of Angel's movements. He's got no alibi. He's toast.
Just picked fruit market. I wonder if Angel gets all his groceries from this place.
Hello?
LAPD, ma'am. Did you hear a disturbance last night?
Yes. Yes, I did. Mrs. Maldonado lit out of here and her husband ran out after her.
You saw this, Miss...
Aranda. I had the door open a crack.
Did you see Mr. Maldonado come back inside after he ran out?
No. I didn't.
Thanks. We'll be in touch.
I kept thinking you were going to call that one a nosy old hag too, Phelps. Well-executed restraint.
I'm executing restraint right now, Finbar.
sorry about that. I'm playing with my kids. LAPD, were you here last night?
Yeah. My wife and I are separated, and I had the kids last night. I put them to bed early and went to bed myself.
Thanks.
Haven't we talked enough already?
No good. There's nobody here.
What do you want?
LAPD. We're making some inquiries.
Make it quick. I work nights.
So you weren't home last night?
No. I was at work.
You know nothing about Mrs. Maldonado fighting with her husband?
Those two? They're always screaming the place down.
Thanks.
Not everything here is going to be relevant.
Hey, honey, what time did you get off waiting table?
My eggs were running.
Sam has taken me to Palm Springs for the weekend.
Where's that goddamn waitress?
He drove me up to Mulholland and we did some looking.
You ought to meet Joe's buddy. He's nice, really.
You want a tip? Refill my coffee next time, honey.
Did you cover my shift on Wednesday? I have not.
Sir, do you work here?
Sorry, pal, just making deliveries.
From where?
Just Pick Fruit Market across the street.
A fruit market delivers here?
Yeah, sure does. The Mexes love a little slice with their tequila.
We found a crate a lot like the ones you're wheeling there, except it was filled with booze. You know anything about that?
What? No, we deliver all over the place, officer. No telling where the boxes end up. Excuse me, I have to get on with this.
Fine, thanks.
It's him, the cop from the newspapers.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
Messages for me, please.
Message from Captain Donnelly, Detective. Your presence is requested urgently at Central Station. A new letter from the Dahlia killer has been found.
Thanks for your help. Another letter? I thought the letter was from a nut.
These letters? Brown and Hanson believe they are genuine. From him.
And now we sent another.
You know, I really hate this fuck. This Black Dahlia guy. Have you seen the body? The fucking case just gnaws away at your guts. Hollywood. Every prom queen from every fucking hick town in America turns up here. Where do they end up? Gutted on the fucking sidewalk.
Captain is waiting for you downstairs with Pinker.
The mouthpiece tore strips off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head.
We gonna go downstairs and see Donnelly or what?
Rehab, I want to be homicide. You know you made it. Get that desk.
Don't go there. Were you there? They're waiting down at tech service.
I want to make homicide. You know you made it if you get that desk.
I need a drink.
I got the jitters again.
Isn't he a cop who won the medal and is solving all the cases?
I saved a whole year for that car!
I don't need this.
Boys, come on in. Phelps, have you met Finnis Brown?
Pleased to meet you, sir.
This information is confidential and doesn't leave this room.
The new letter was left in the back seat of a cab. The driver thinks it was put through the window and not left by a customer.
We're checking all his fares back 24 hours regardless.
Good.
Like the previous letters, it's been assembled from headlines and type from the Times and Examiner, then glued to an envelope.
What is the other note?
This one? That's also new. A poem, hand-typed.
Do you mind if I take a look?
Go ahead. We've been over both documents pretty carefully. They've been wiped with gasoline, so there's no chance of prints.
That's the message from the Celine Henry case.
Guy gave his wife a tap. I'd say all's fair in love and war.
Upon thy soul by virtue of this curse.
That's why we called you in.
Do you think it's original?
Not unless he's a genius.
You like this nutjob's poem?
No, I like Shelley. It was written at least 100 years ago.
Shelley? Sure, I knew that.
You see, Finnis, I told you this lad was a bright boy.
Sure, but what has it got to do with the case?
Prometheus Unbound. Prometheus was a titan, a superhuman character who defied the gods to bring fire to humanity.
The Dahlia guy believes he's Superman.
Your guess is as good as mine. One thing for sure is that he's educated. What about the link to the Henry case?
He could have got the wording from the papers. As you said, he is fiendishly clever and takes pleasure in taunting us. What's happening with the Maldonado case?
We have the husband in custody. We haven't interviewed him yet.
Well, upstairs then, lads, and see if we can break him.
I saved a whole year for that car!
Isn't he a cop who won the medal and is solving all the cases?
I've been in this job 20 years. I never fired my gun.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to stop him with one round.
Improved your attitude, Angel?
What do you want me to say? I was with Antonia the night she died, but she left the apartment, and that was the last time I saw her.
So your wife paid you a visit last night. What time was that?
Late, around midnight, maybe. She didn't stay long.
You're lying, Angel. You went after her. I think you killed her.
You're out of your mind. My brother will tell you I was at home.
We have a witness who confirms that you were arguing, that your wife ran out, that you followed her, and didn't come back.
I know this looks bad, but it's not true. We argued, all right? But she went out, and I went out after her, and she jumped in a car on the corner.
There was a car waiting for her? Can you describe the driver?
Not the driver. It was too dark. But the car. It was a brown Ford coupe.
You and your wife weren't getting along. She was divorcing you. Is that why you killed her?
We fought, yeah, but we weren't getting a divorce.
I don't believe you, Angel. She'd been granted a decree nigh sigh. She pushed you too far, and you lashed out.
I told you. I wouldn't accept a divorce.
The judge had set a date. You were going to be paraded in front of the whole city for your cruelty to her, Angel.
Antonia. Oh, Jesus. She came in drunk, out of her mind. She doesn't normally drink. She was looking around in her bag. Said she wanted to serve me papers. Me, her own husband. So I slapped her down. She ran out. That's the truth.
What size shoe do you wear, Angel?
Size 8. What difference does that make?
When we found your wife, her jewelry had been removed. Was she wearing her religious medallion last night?
Sure. She always wore that.
What about the charm bracelet? Was she wearing that?
You know about that? She never wore it. She didn't like the message. She kept it locked up in that box of hers.
Your wife has been brutally murdered. So how do you explain your shirt being covered in blood?
You found that? I cut myself shaving.
Angel, I'm not going to waste any more time on this. Give me something or I'm going to have you charged.
My brother, Ippolito, he said some bad things about Antonia last night. So I had to sock him one. We got into it.
Keep talking.
She said she came from the El Dorado bar.
And?
It's not one of my places. We used to buy fruit at the market down the street. But the creep there was always running his eyes all over my wife.
What's the name of this fruit market?
Just picked fruit. Ord Street downtown.
One last question, Angel. Do the words kiss the blood mean anything to you?
No. Sounds sick to me.
You're not in the clear by any means, Angel. You're going back into a cell. You should think about whether you have anything else you need to share with us.
I'm not here. I'm a Parker, Wolverine. I don't know who these are.
say we bust in there and find the goddamn letter.
What's your read on Maldonado?
I still like him for it. Seriously, that line about the guy at the fruit market making eyes at his woman? Please. Now, we'll get to the market and the guy behind the counter will tell us he saw Angel drag his old lady off into the night. This case will be shut like all the others.
Sir, wait, you look familiar.
Hey, from the bar, right? What brings you here?
LAPD, Detective Phelps and Galloway.
Clem Feeney, what can I do for you?
Did you happen to see a young woman last night? 21 years old, Hispanic?
Sure, she came by last night. Why do you ask?
She was wearing a necklace?
I didn't notice.
You weren't paying attention, Feeney?
Hey, you're getting the wrong idea.
Exactly how much fruit do you sell here after midnight, Clem?
Look, not much. I sell the odd bottle on the side to the after-hours crowd. Look, I don't want any trouble. I'm just trying to make a buck.
The young lady arrived around midnight?
Yeah, something like that. Used the phone for a cab and then left.
You already knew Mrs. Maldonado, didn't you, Clem?
Sure, I met her before. Now, she seemed like a nice lady. Her husband went apeshit one day when he caught me talking to her. She hadn't been back until last night.
Where did she go from here?
She wanted a cab, but I couldn't get her one. I was about to offer to drive her, but a car pulled up and she got into that.
Can you describe the car?
Brown Ford Coupe, I think. She seemed to know the guy.
Do you mind if we look around?
Why would you want to do that?
Because we say so.
I guess you can. Don't you have to get a court order or something? I have rights.
Clem?
Shh.
No wonder he stays open late at night. If People have to get their vitamins. Check through this stuff before we get back out there.
So what are we hiding in here? This thing needs a combination.
I just don't know how to dance to bebop.
Cut someone who was already dead.
It's a typical power thing. Once the stiff is dead, the creep usually feels they can do whatever they like. You must have seen it during the war. This fruit stall punk gets about 10 seconds to explain before I pull his fucking arms off.
Clem!
God damn it, get after him, Cole! I'll try to shoot out his tires. Wish me luck.
We should have grabbed him when we had the chance, Phelps.
When we had the chance, we didn't know he was our guy.
Phelps, you gotta get me closer.
Strange that he'd leave a trail of blood right back to his own market.
Maybe he wanted to be caught. A lot of them do.
It's almost too perfect, isn't it?
There's no such thing as too perfect.
Hit him, Cole! Spin him out! I'll try to shoot out his tires. Wish me luck.
Sick man, Clem. You need help.
Outstanding job on this case, gentlemen. The poor woman can now rest in peace. I'll pay the fiend a personal visit myself and remind him that crime in this city does not go unpunished. When they finish with him at the receiving hospital, we'll have him up before the grand jury. I have a meeting this afternoon with the mayor, lads. I'll be sure to mention your names. Now, on your way.
Sarge, why are the guys giving it to the doggies?
They're riding in trucks, numbskull, while you're marching.
They look pretty badly beat up.
Yeah, they do it then. Scuttlebutt says it's pretty hard going down south.
Yeah, we'll find out soon enough. Recon always leads.
How can we fail, Skip, with the Shadow leading the show?
What the fuck is a Shadow?
Lieutenant Phelps, the Shadow of Death.
What the fuck are you talking about?
He's a quiet fucker, Sarge. Never hear the bastard coming.
You're sitting there, field stripping a cigarette, and suddenly he's there looking down on you.
Why do you think we keep saluting that Jap-loving son of a bitch? He's bad juju.
That's enough out of you three! Bad juju? Where were you dragged up? A swamp?
Good morning, gentlemen, and what a grand morning it is, too. We have just cause for celebration. Galloway and Phelps are sending another fiend to San Quentin. A nice showy trial, and he'll be strapped down with gas seeping into his tiny reptile brain. Now, the fresh business. Galloway and Phelps, the task is at hand. The address is on the hill, north downtown off Fremont Avenue.
You ought to meet Joe's buddy. It's nice.
Skipper, is the new letter genuine?
Now, boys, we all know how many imbeciles have confessed in the short case. Ray Pinker will let us know in good time.
I was door knocking all morning, but I got a make on the car.
Fine morning indeed. We keep locking them up, but the bodies keep piling up.
Yeah, California's love a fad, Phelps. As long as the bricks hold up at San Quentin, there'll always be killers in this town to send.
He's good looking for a policeman. Whoa!
Greetings from sunny California. I don't want to stop.
He wants a 5-star goddamn wedding.
First the letter, and now another body. Come on, you can't keep on telling me there's not a killer still out there.
You know, Phelps, all these arrests and the racket have given me a reputation. You don't want them turning into unsolved.
Getting a vicious killer off the streets is more important than my reputation.
Really?
And besides, landing a big fat marlin is more impressive than an ocean full of minnows.
The minnows maketh the man, Phelps. You can't always hit home runs. Sometimes you just gotta make first base.
Thank you.
That guy there will lead us up.
I'm steeling myself from what I'm about to see.
That'll just be another dead body, Carter. It used the same. With a good break. Run, you fucking idiot!
Phelps and Galloway, homicide. Scene secure. The rest of the patrolmen are going door to door, canvassing for witnesses.
Thanks. Keep me informed.
Will do, Detective.
This looks awfully familiar.
I think that's the impression the boys from the Examiner took with them as well.
There's nothing original under the sun. Why should murder be any different?
What do we have so far?
Not much trace evidence to speak of. Storm blew in around 10 last night, and the rain washed most of it away.
And the body?
Looks like she was tipped out of an automobile from the tire tracks and superficial injuries. Strangled with a length of rope. And for my money, it's triple braid again.
Time of death?
From her temperature, maybe 2 a.m. But it was cold last night.
Usual head injuries.
Blunt force trauma. Knock him over the head, then strangle and mutilate. No message with this one.
At least she was left clothed.
I doubt very much he was concerned with her dignity.
The green silk dress is very distinctive. Any sign of her other shoe?
No. And no handbag or other personal effects.
There appears to be a dry cleaning label. Superior Laundry Services, F1363. No drag marks. The killer was moving around, surveying the scene. Our driver and our killer are most likely one and the same.
Detectives, I've been working the houses across the street and up the block. This lady thinks she has something for us.
Detective Phelps, LAPD.
I'm Mrs. Barton, Catherine Barton. I live just across the way.
Did you see anyone around here last night?
Not last night, but yesterday, early evening, I saw that awful hobo.
Do you have a description?
Tall, gaunt, horribly disfigured. I think he may have had an accident in the war. He's a very scary, angry man.
Any idea where we might find him?
One of the hobo camps around here. He's some kind of hobo leader. They all follow him around.
Thank you, ma'am. You've been a big help.
Of course. Anything I can do to help. I'd hate to think that something so ghastly could happen right here and nothing be done about it.
What are we waiting for? Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on Superior Laundry Services.
Just a moment. Superior Laundry Services, 1260 West 1st Street.
Can you track down reports of hobo camps in the vicinity of Signal Hill?
Just a moment, Detective. There's a large camp under the bridge on Grand between Temple and Sunset.
Thanks, ma'am.
No message.
Excuse me?
There was no message.
Where?
On the Vic. The last bodies had something written onto them. This one didn't.
I'm failing to follow you.
Can't be the same guy is what I'm saying, right? Before you start trying to link this to Maldonado and all the others.
There are more factors to consider than the messages, Rusty.
This doesn't fit your pattern, Cole. End of conversation. Understand?
Thank you.
At least the rain stopped. Change back into those white bucks now.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. We're investigating a case, and one of your laundry labels came up. F1363.
If you give me a minute, I'll go find a register and you can take a look. You take a look for yourself. I've got clothes that need pressing.
You wrote the number down on that dress, is it there?
Terrellson, 43 Emerald Street, Westlake.
I've got a feeling we're about to meet another wife killer.
You've always got that feeling, Rusty.
Yeah, and it's usually correct.
Please, please, for once, can you not let your assumptions color your detective work?
Just you wait. Nordic types show a particular disposition for this stuff.
Hello? Yes?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. Is your wife home, sir?
My wife went out last night and she hasn't come home.
Can you describe your wife and what she was wearing?
We were out at a friend's place, Bobby Ross's, for a party. She was kind of dolled up. She had her green silk dress, open-toed white shoes. Those are her favorite shoes.
Can we come in, Mr. Tarleton? I'm afraid we have some rather bad news. Do you have someone who can look after your children, Mr.?
I've been trying to arrange a sitter. Look, tell me what's happened.
I'm afraid your wife was murdered last night. Her body was found this morning. We're very sorry for your loss. I know this is a difficult time, Mr. Tarleton, but we are going to need you to answer some questions. First, we're going to take a look around.
What for? You don't think
it's
that...
It's procedure. You see to your girls.
Stay here till Daddy's finished talking to these men.
Where's Mommy?
Everything's gonna be all right, sweetheart.
We would like Mommy to come home now, Daddy.
What's the problem, Tarleton? Let him search. You got nothing to hide. You want to hear something funny, Tarleton? Some bums think filling out a missing persons report actually rules them out as a suspect.
Need to check if she was a regular. Baron's Bar again. Someone must be real sweet on this dive. I wonder why the picture was turned down. If you'd excuse me, ladies. Maybe. No. So she went out without her handbag? She'd have to be in quite a state to leave this behind. At least she was spared that particular indignity. See if Pinker can match the impression to the crime scene.
ours was out in the rain last night. Like a match with the ligature marks.
I'm going up to the lakes to watch the races on Saturday.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
Can you run an address for a Bobby Ross? Then send some uniforms over.
Would you like him picked up?
No. Suspect says he was with Ross last night. We need to confirm the alibi.
I'll get a prowl car dispatched.
Thank you.
For the record, Mr. Tarleton, what is your wife's name?
Teresa.
Do you have any idea why anyone would want to hurt your wife?
No. Everyone loved Teresa. She was so full of life. It can't be anyone who knew her.
I think you're lying, Lars. I think you were mad at your wife for embarrassing you in front of your friends. I think you came back here and strangled her and then dumped her body on the hill.
You think I strangled my wife? How do you expect to prove that?
Your wife was strangled with triple braid rope. The bowline from your boat is a perfect match.
Look, I know this looks bad. I'm gonna have to come to terms with the fact that I let her go.
You said you went to a party at Bobby Ross's place?
That's right. Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave.
You let your drunk wife leave the party and go off on her own?
Look, I was angry. I was having a good time. She has to go and ruin it. We always have to do what she wants to do. Last night she wanted to go dancing.
Any idea where?
Where she always goes. A bar down on North Beaudry Avenue. Baron's Bar. She goes there, drinks too much, gets maudlin, and calls me. I go and bring her home.
Mr. Tarleton, was Teresa happy at home?
Yeah, I think she was.
Spill it, Tarleton. We like the look of you for this, so you better give us something.
We're at the party. She has a few and says she wants to go out dancing. We only have the sitter until 9. I get mad. I tell her to go ahead, but I'm staying. She storms out. Look, I'm doing well at cards. I hardly ever do well. I married her because she was so much fun, but now she drives me fucking crazy.
What time did she leave the party?
About 8:30, maybe a little earlier.
When was the last time you saw your wife?
Around 8:30. The card game at Bobby's was wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here. I paid the sitter and went to bed.
You're lying, Lars. You didn't come straight home, did you?
And how do you figure that?
You were out in the rain. You got soaked, Lars. We found your wet weather gear.
Okay, I stayed a little later than I said. This cute little brunette was hitting on me. Teresa noticed. I was half cut. I walked her home from Bobby's, but nothing happened. I walked back and got the car this morning.
Thanks for answering our questions, Mr. Tarleton. You'll need to go downtown to identify your wife's body.
I should have taken her dancing.
In my experience, Mac, if you give in to broads, you'll be giving in to them your entire life. Sounds like the Tarleton broad had her last drink at Baron's Bar. We should check the place out.
Appreciate your time, sir.
I recognize that guy from the papers. He's a cop.
You believe this guy's story?
Kind of rings true.
Gents, drink?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD.
I'm Benny Clough. This about Teresa Tarleton?
Yes, it is.
I heard about it on the radio. They're saying it was that Black Dahlia freak again? God damn it. Yeah, I rang that husband of hers. The babysitter said he was out.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions. What time did Teresa leave?
Around 10:30, I think.
On foot, in a car, by bus, how was it?
She called for a cab.
Did you get the number?
Sure I did. I like Teresa. The only time she has a drink is when things aren't going so good at home. I was worried about her.
God damn it all, I asked them to hold the mail.
Put out an APB on the cab. 3591. Should be traceable.
Find a seat.
Who was
was she with? We've had reports about a tall, gaunt-looking hobo. He wasn't here last night?
I get plenty of bums in here, but nothing to fit that description.
The likelihood is that whoever she left here with killed her. Give it up, Benny.
All right, two creeps were all over her, promising to take her dancing.
You get a good look at these guys?
Sure. I got a good look. One of them was a sailor in uniform. His cap said, USS Indiana.
And the other man?
The other guy is Richard Bates. He's sitting in the back right now, red polo shirt.
Any idea where she was headed?
Nope. I didn't get that.
The husband said she wanted to go dancing.
And she always wants to dance when she's been drinking. She was trying to talk some guys into taking her to one of the dance halls.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Fluff. We'll take it from here.
Hey, no problem.
This is Bates.
That's him.
LAPD, don't make me chase you, shitbird. We can't let the son of a bitch get away.
My eggs were running.
Bates! We just want to talk.
Come on, we gotta ride. Get in and drive.
No time to
wait. I thought you were gonna leave me there.
Who knows what this guy will pull when he's cornered. We could have a killer on our hands. I don't think the killer would be kicking back in the bar where he met the victim.
Listen, a creature of habit is your killer. For some reason, they're sticklers for routine. Don't go to sleep on me. Get me back in close. Hit him, Cole. Spit him out.
He's showing you how it's done. Maybe you shouldn't have waited for me, Phelps.
Hit him! Clean this asshole off the road!
Let's end this farce.
All right, you got me. I've had enough.
Put your hands where I can see them.
Lord in heaven!
Okay, Bates. You're gonna answer some questions.
I have a choice in this.
Last night, you went drinking with a lady in the bar. Now she's dead, and your face is all messed up.
I'm in the clear on that. She preferred a sailor. You could lay it off on him. Are we finished?
Do you want my partner to sap you? Tell us what we want to know.
She was okay. Drunk, pissed off at her old man, wanting to go dancing. I thought I'd ply her with a few drinks and get my end away. Looks like your salty had the same idea.
So what happened when you left the bar?
Sailor boy laid one on me, a cheap shot. After that, I don't know.
You've done time, haven't you, Richard? Is that why you ran?
I'm on parole.
On what offense?
Sexual assault. Look. I was lying there on the sidewalk. He flags a cab and jumps in with the broad.
We're taking you in, Bates.
How come?
Just for a chat. Nice, private chat. I'll explain my theory of once a degenerate, always a degenerate.
Take him to Central. He's a material witness in a murder case. Find him a cozy cell.
Richard here knows the drill.
that the cop who solved the big case and got promoted?
Car 11 King to KGPL.
KGPL, go ahead, 11 King.
I need an APB out on a yellow cab, number 3591. Relay all sightings to 11K.
INS also needs help. 415 and shots fired. 313 Bunker Hill Avenue. 313 Bunker Hill Avenue. Unit to handle code 3 identify.
Car 11K, we have a response on your APB.
Belt 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
Were there any incident reports filed in the vicinity of Barron's Bar on North Beaudry Avenue? Or tracking a sailor who was involved in a fight outside the bar?
I can check the reports, Detective. I have a message for you from Captain Donnelly. Message reads, James Jessup, U.S. Navy able seaman, has information relevant to your case. Jessup is currently being detained at Central Station.
Could be our man. Thanks.
Where's that cab got to now? See our taxi anywhere?
INS also needs help. 415 and shots fired. 313 Bunker Hill Avenue. 313 Bunker Hill Avenue. Unit to handle code 3 identify.
If you want to leave that one to the uniform, that's fine. We've got plenty to get off.
I got the jitters again.
He's in interview two.
Thanks. What do you make of him?
Sailor on furlough, who looks like he's in trouble and knows it.
Hey, I gave his wife a tap. I said all fair in love and war.
I gave his wife a tap. I said all fair in love and war.
Hey, don't mind me.
Sirs?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway. We know why you're here, Jessup, so it would be best if you answered our questions truthfully.
I don't want any trouble. That's why I'm here. I heard on the radio about this lady getting killed. I got leave from my CO to come down straight away.
So why did you kill her?
I didn't kill anyone. Look, you need to believe me.
Let's start at the beginning. You went to Baron's Bar. What time did you arrive?
I got a 24-hour pass. I got there around 7.
That's where you met Teresa Terrelson?
Sure. We had a couple of drinks.
So you tried to make a woman who was incredibly drunk?
Look, I'm not proud of myself, but I never hurt her.
You took her dancing?
That's right. Caught a cab to the Crystal Ballroom.
You had a fist fight with Richard Bates over Mrs. Terrelson.
You met the guy? He's a creep. You should take a look at him for this.
He's pointing the finger directly at you, Jessup.
I only had one night before I was back in the tub. He had all the time in the world to look for some action. I belted him. I'd do it again. She was better off with me.
Sure. You're a shining example of chivalry, Jessup. We're holding you till we can clear this with the driver.
Yeah, my CO said as much.
Can you put the guy in 2 in a cell and inform the commander?
Sure, detective. Got a message for you. Sighting of your disfigured hobo on Grand between Temple and Sunset. And it looks like the beau has a record, too. He's wanted in connection with 2 female assaults.
Thanks.
This guy must have escaped the loony bin.
Three suspects, either can and one on the hoof. And still no hard evidence on any of them.
KGP, Elsicar 11K. 11K, come in.
I got your plate.
11K, go ahead.
Everyone reporting that Bobby Ross's car game is breaking up at midnight.
11K, roger that. Plenty of time to get downtown, Cole.
It's possible. Have them bring him in.
KGPL, we have Lars Terrelson picked up.
11K, roger.
I think we ought to investigate the hobo lead.
Well, if you think we ought to, then I guess we ought. Gently.
LAPD, we'd like a word with you.
Save it for someone who's interested. They're fascists. Come to move us on and steal what little we have left.
6 rounds won't get us far.
We need you to stay close to 7. You need to hold out for cavalry.
How do we do that?
By this.
If you want your rightful share, we need to fight for it.
Killing make you feel powerful.
Doing them a favor, partner.
What are you doing, Joe Lewis?
What's your name?
Comrade Stalin.
Very funny. We'll find out from your personal effects.
Stuart Ackerman.
You're under suspicion for murder, Ackerman. We're taking you downtown.
You can't do anything more to me than what the Japanese have already done.
The Kremlin's over here, Phelps. Toss it, see what you find.
Looks familiar. Safe bet it'll match the mark under Teresa Terrellson's chin. Ackerman doesn't look like much of a dancer.
Still working, Jack. I'm off to the Lighthouse Club in Santa Monica.
Hello, Jack.
Mr. Benson, this is Courtney Sheldon. He's a buddy of mine from the war.
Well, I'm sure you two will want to polish some old war stories. Good evening, Jack. Mr. Sheldon.
Good night, sir. Take a seat, Courtney.
We need your help, Jack.
I told you I would have nothing to do with that.
I'm fine too, Jack. Medical school's going well. I got a part-time job.
Do dope peddlers need part-time jobs?
We made a mistake and we're in trouble, Jack. A local gangster, Mickey Cohen, is putting on the squeeze.
So hand it over, walk away. What's stopping you?
We had a deal with them that they would dole it out slowly. They said they would supply abortion clinics and doctors, but they've been moving it on to addicts. And they can't cope with the purity.
So your problem is with gangsters being dishonest?
My problem is that people are dying. And that if this gets back to us, we'll all end up in jail.
So how am I supposed to help, Courtney? This isn't the war. I can't just wave a magic wand and clean up your mess.
We want you to negotiate, Jack.
The only thing these guys understand is force, Sheldon. They got to the top back east by proving to be more vicious than the English, the Irish, and the Dutch. They make their own laws. That's the nature of a secret society. God's sake, Courtney, you want to be a doctor. How can you fight with that?
We are better trained.
I didn't make it through the war to come back to this kind of shit, Sheldon.
Slow down! That's disgusting. Didn't you ever hear of germs?
Oh.
The husband has an alibi, but no real motive other than neglect. Jessup's alibi checks out. Bates is a recidivist. He'll be pulling the same shtick until we put him away for good. Ackerman has history, opportunity, hard evidence. What motive?
We have the evidence. We know she was here. All we need is a confession and we can charge the bum with murder. We're going this way.
That bum took a swipe at me. I put him down in my sap.
I say we bust in there and find the goddamn evidence.
They weren't even his friends, and he still thinks that.
Do I need to find someone to drop in the room? No way. How long is this gonna take?
Oh, you're the first in your family born without a tail.
Come on, Phelps, on your bike.
Why is the word abbreviation so long?
Coroner says it's going to be at least a week to get an ID.
Can you bring me the car?
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to the 45.
Ackerman, you were in the Marines.
How do you know?
The Corps selected big guys for flamethrower duty. That's how you got the burns.
Life expectancy was 5 minutes for a guy in flamethrower detail. What kind of a government puts weight like that on a man's shoulders?
You'll get no argument from me. It was a heavy load.
You feeling sorry for this smelly fuck?
Why did you kill Mrs. Terrellson?
I have no recollection of the people I have killed.
Are you denying that you strangled Mrs. Terrellson with a length of rope?
I'm not denying anything. You have to have proof, lackey.
You trying to sit me down? What the hell is the LAPD up to these days? That's right. Am I going to get out of here tonight?
We found a matching piece of rope in your lean-to. I think we'll find the blood will match, too.
I own no property. How could it belong to me?
A bus driver dropped Mrs. Terrellson near your camp around 2 a.m. Why did you take her up to the hill?
Which hill? I have many places. I go where I please.
You are clearly insane, Ackerman. The state of California does not execute mental patients.
I don't know the names of the women I've killed, but I've killed many of them. Their necks are so fragile.
Stuart Ackerman, I am charging you with the murder of Teresa Terrellson.
A man down on his luck, I can abide. But a filthy red who chooses to live outside the rules of society, I cannot stomach. Maybe poor Theresa Terrellson will provide the catalyst we need. I've spoken to the chief and the mayor, and I think it's time we send some men in to remove the godless and send them on their way over the county line. A grand day that will be, gentlemen. And a grand result you have brought me. You two are fast becoming my finest crusaders.
the flames in me. And now my heart's a blazing ruin. You say that you were only fooling. Don't walk away. Don't do me wrong. Don't leave me singing this torched song.
Of course we will look into it. Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year. Keep a hold of your hat, Counselor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve. It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawn broker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue. We have another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
I say we bust in there and find the goddamn evidence.
Ну что ж, на этом пока что все. Продолжение следует. Не забывайте на мой канал ставить лайки, ставить комментарии. Всем заранее спасибо.